Can Bible verses be inspiring in fighting climate change? Maybe. In the Netherlands, a carpenter has embarked on a spectacular adventure. Following the instructions in the Old Testament, he built a faithful copy of Noah's Ark. Jan Huyber had this idea after having a nightmare about a great flood devastating his country. He believes that global warming is a natural process where human activity has no influence.
It was starting already after Noah, 4,000 years ago. And it will keep on going, and it became hotter, and the ocean became higher. Yeah, it's global warming. So what's coming in the next years, I don't know, but flood will come, absolutely.
The vessel has a religious purpose to teach the story of the Bible. It is 122 meters long and 23 meters high. It can host 4,000 people and 15,000 species of animals.
Building an ark to survive a great flood might seem a little bit odd. Nevertheless, the risk of new flooding is more realistic than ever. Global warming is already upsetting the climate, and things might get worse in the future.
According to a recent study, in the next decades, Western and Central Europe will face more river floods and the rise of water sea level. The effects of global warming will be inevitable, experts say, but the scale depends on how many degrees the world heats up.
What we think is that 1.5, that is adaptable, and maybe 2, but beyond 2, we simply don't know if we are able to adapt. It could be that areas like Antarctica could become unstable and shift more quickly into the sea, and that would lead to incredible sea level rises.
Experts urge cities to adapt their urban infrastructure to deal with rising water levels. Elena Cavallone, Euronews, Rotterdam.